Welcome, my dear students, in the class 12th of English. I am Rashmi, lecturer, AD Government Girls Inter College, Gorakhpur, and today I am going to start the second chapter of prose. The name of the lesson is A Fellow Traveler by A.G. Gardiner. Dear students, this word fellow, I hope you must be familiar to this word. Fellow means a companion. So you must have heard the words like class fellow, school fellow, play fellow. So in this way, the fellow is quite familiar to you. Now we have to analyze a fellow traveler. A fellow traveler means a companion during the journey, during traveling. In this way, we have to find out here who is this fellow traveler and what kind of experience here the author goes through. In this way, all these things will be unveiled to you as we proceed in our studies. So, first of all, we will look at the objectives of the lesson. The first objective is to understand the value of freedom. When you read this lesson, you find out that freedom is the most prominent theme in this essay. Second, to grasp the theme of the essay, as we read any paragraph, it's quite essential to know about the theme of the essay, then we can have a better understanding of that particular text. Third, to locate the difficult words. Dear students, it is also very necessary to know the meaning of difficult words. In this way, you can enhance your vocabulary treasure. Fourth, to interpret the ideas and events. What are the main ideas in the text and what are the main events that we will come to know when we study this lesson? Fifth, to recognize the different elements of language, structure, vocabulary and pronunciation. These are the basic features of prose, and as we are going to read the lesson, we will come to know all these things. So here we have the objectives. Let's move towards the famous author A.G. Gardiner. A.G. Gardiner, the full name of A.G. Gardiner was Alfred George Gardiner, and generally we say A.G. Gardiner, was a British journalist, editor, essayist and author. Second, his essay written under the pen name Alpha of the Plough are highly regarded. Third, birth 2nd June 1885, England, death 3rd March 1946, England. Here we have about his major works, Prophets, Priests, Kings, in the year 1908. Second, Pebbles on the Shore, 1916. Third, The Pillars of Society, 1913. The Warlords, 1915. Leaves in the Wind, 1920. Now, the fifth point is quite important. As we see here, he was genius of describing ordinary things in an exceptionally interesting manner. Dear students, when you come to know about the lesson, you will feel yourself what has been written here, what has been pointed out here, that he had the ability to make ordinary things in an extraordinary way. Now, this was a brief introduction of the essay. Now we have the characters of the essay. First, the author or the narrator himself is the character, and the second is the fellow traveler. Yes, dear students, here is the fellow traveler, and the fellow traveler is mosquito. I had already told it to you that this mystery will be unveiled to you as we are here in the character of the essay. So, what is special here? That we had in our imagination that the character would be, the fellow traveler would be a human being. But contrary to it, contrary to our imagination, here we have the fellow traveler, that is a mosquito. And I must tell you, this is going to be a very interesting and amazing experience for you. Now, this was the brief introduction of the essay. Let's have the theme of the essay. The first theme is uncertainty. The lesson starts with the note of uncertainty. Because what does the author say? He says that I do not know who of us entered into the carriage first. So here we find the note of uncertainty. He does not know the mosquito came first or the author himself. Second, freedom. I had already told it to you that freedom is the most prominent theme in the essay. Here we have a quite amazing experience about freedom. And the author says, whenever we get the opportunity to feel freedom, or we can be full free in our life, we should try to avail the opportunity of being free. Here in this lesson, as you read, you will find out that the author wants to avail the opportunity of freedom. It's another matter, due to circumstances, he does not get the opportunity. Third, generosity. When the author finds himself unable to accomplish his goal, that was to kill the mosquito, generosity occurs. So at that point of time, we find the theme of generosity. Then comes equality. Here we find the same passage for the mosquito too. Earlier it had not been present, this theme, but with the passage of time, the author felt a kind of equality for the mosquito. Next comes modesty. When he gets totally tired, he feels that he needs to be modest. He needs to be liberal. He needs to be merciful. So, how does it happen? We will see in the analysis of the paragraph. So, let's move towards the lesson at a glance. First of all, we will have a brief knowledge about the lesson. After that, we will keep on analyzing the paragraph. So, the author was traveling in a passenger train from London to Midland Town. Actually, the entire incident takes place in the compartment of a train. So, the author was going from London to the Midland Town. In the end, he was left alone in the compartment. There will be compartment, not apartment. So he was traveling in the compartment, and ultimately he found himself, or you can say it seemed to him that he was alone in the compartment. He wanted to avail this opportunity as enjoying full freedom. Dear students, here you need to feel that, how do you feel if you travel in a train and you are totally alone in that particular compartment? So if you try to analyze, two things may occur. First, either you will be quite fearful. On the other hand, there will be a group of people who will feel quite free. When we look at the lesson from the author's point of view, he feels that it's a kind of opportunity and it's a good thing if you are traveling alone in the compartment, because you can exercise your whole power at that time and nobody will come to you and check it. So in this way, he says that opportunity as enjoying full freedom rather than feeling loneliness. There is no need to feel loneliness in the compartment because you have a lot of things to do in the compartment when you are traveling alone. Then he found he was not alone. He had a great feeling of freedom when he found that he is totally alone in the compartment. But what happens next? He finds that there is the partner, there is a fellow traveler, and who is it? It is the mosquito. So at first he got irritated because it was a kind of hindrance for him. He was dreaming of something and mosquito came as an obstacle, as a hurdle. At first he got irritated and wanted to kill the mosquito. He was quite angry. He wanted to kill the mosquito. Then he realized that he and the mosquito were fellow mortals in this world. When we read the entire paragraph, at last we find that the author gets philosophical. He says that we both of us have the same position. We are fellow mortals, we have the same history and we have the same destination, and in this way we are quite unknown to our destination. We don't know where have we to go after death. So he starts thinking about the life and its journey and became a philosopher. In this way, dear students, we have the lesson at a glance. You must have got the idea of the lesson. Now let's move towards the analysis. Here we have paragraph 1 to 3rd, and we will try to analyze the paragraph 1, 2 and 3 in this slide. The first, the author was traveling in a passenger train from London to a Midland town. You have already come to know it. He called it an infinitely leisurely train because it was moving at a very slow speed. The writer was traveling in a train. That train was called infinitely leisurely train. The reason was that the train was a passenger train. It stopped at every station. So it seemed to him that the train had immense time, leisurely train. The passengers got down in ones and twos at the wayside stations, and in the end he was left alone in the compartment. Ultimately, he found himself totally alone in the compartment. The sense of being alone in the compartment was interesting for him. He could do anything he liked. So it opened up a basket of good things, full of basket. So here we find that he was quite happy when he found himself quite alone in the compartment. He thought now he was free to do what he liked. Author, लेखक इसमें लंदन से मिडलैंड टाउन की तरफ ट्रेन से यात्रा कर रहे थे और वो जिस ट्रेन में यात्रा कर रहे थे ऐसा प्रतीत हो रहा था, ऐसा लग रहा था कि उस ट्रेन के पास बहुत सारा समय है, खाली समय है। और वो बहुत ही क्यों ऐसा कहा गया? क्योंकि उस ट्रेन की स्पीड, उसकी गति बहुत धीमी थी। पैसेंजर गॉट डाउन, एक दो करके पैसेंजर्स यात्री हर स्टेशन पे उतरते गए और लास्ट में ऑथर जो है, लेखक हैं, वो अकेले उस कंपार्टमेंट में, उस डिब्बे में बच गए। कहानी यहाँ से शुरू होती है। इसके बाद द सेंस ऑफ बीइंग अलोन, जब आप किसी ट्रेन के डिब्बे में बच्चों एकदम अकेले होते हैं तो आपको उस समय अपने स्वतंत्रता को महसूस करने का भरपूर अवसर होता है, जैसा कि लेखक ने यहाँ पे महसूस किया। इसके पीछे रीज़न ये है कि आप कुछ भी उस समय कर सकते हैं जो आप करना चाहते हैं। बच्चों, आप इस चीज़ को महसूस करके देखिएगा कि आप ये कल्पना करिए कि अगर आप किसी ट्रेन में जा रहे हैं और आप बिल्कुल अकेले हैं तो आप कैसा अनुभव करते हैं। निश्चित रूप से आपके मन में एक अच्छा अनुभव आएगा। अगर आप बहुत सकारात्मक सोचते हैं, या तो भय हो सकता है या अकेलेपन का डर भी हो सकता है, लेकिन जहाँ तक लेखक की बात है, उनके दिमाग में आया कि ये उनके स्वतंत्रता का आनंद उठाने का सबसे सटीक समय है। He could enjoy the luxury of breaking the regulations of DORA, D-O-R-A, that stands for the Defense of Realm Act. Actually, dear students, it was a kind of power given to the British government during the World War 1914. That night, he could not enjoy that freedom because he became aware that he had a unique fellow traveler, and that was mosquito. He wanted to enjoy this opportunity. He wanted to avail this opportunity. He thought that he could sing, he could dance, he could do whatever he liked. So at that time, just he was thinking like that, and meanwhile he found that there was a mosquito as a fellow traveler. Now he found out that he had no opportunity to avail this unique freedom. The mosquito fluttered and took a round in the compartment and found him the most interesting and sat upon his neck. Now here the disturbance begins. And what does the mosquito do? He fluttered, he moved in the entire compartment and found out that the author is the best place to sit over there, and it sat upon his neck. Author यहाँ कहते हैं, लेखक यहाँ कहते हैं कि डोरा के नियमों को तोड़ने का आनंद भी वो उठा सकता था जब वह यात्रा में, उसे लगा कि वह अकेले यात्रा कर रहा है, लेकिन उस दिन वह यह सब सोच ही रहा था, उसे महसूस हुआ कि वो इस यात्रा में अकेले नहीं है बल्कि उसके साथ एक बहुत ही नया सहयात्री है जो कि एक मच्छर है। उसके बाद यहाँ पर कहा गया कि जो मच्छर है वो पूरी ट्रेन के डिब्बे में मडराता रहा और उसे लगा कि इस पूरे ट्रेन के डिब्बे में कोई भी उतना रुचिकर नहीं है जितना कि लेखक, और वो जाकर के लेखक के गर्दन पे बैठ गया। लेट्स हैव द वर्ड मीनिंग। सबर्बन, आउटस्कर्ट ऑफ बिग टाउन, एक बड़े कस्बे का बाहरी क्षेत्र। अलाइटेड, उतरा। लिबर्टी, स्वतंत्रता। हिंड्रेंस, ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन, मतलब बाधा। लिंगर्ड, स्टेट, ठहरा। निपी, शार्प, तेज। इंटरप्रेट, करेजियस, साहसी। इन्वेस्टिगेटेड, निरीक्षण किया, इंस्पेक्टेड। वेगली, नॉट क्लियरली, अस्पष्ट। फ्लटर, फ्लाई बाई फ्लैपिंग द विंग्स क्विकली एंड लाइटली। एंड यू मस्ट हैव सीन, फ्लटर मीन्स मटराना। नेक्स्ट वी हैव द पैराग्राफ फोर्थ एंड फिफ्थ। द फेलो ट्रेवलर मॉस्किटो डिस्टर्ब द ऑथर अगेन एंड अगेन। फर्स्ट ही सेट ऑन द नेक, देन बैक ऑफ द हैंड, then nose. So in this way it was disturbing him again and again he made it fly with a sudden soft blow. So he used his blow also. It came back and sat again boldly. As it was mentioned, the mosquito was quite fearless, so it again sat boldly. The author got angry and told that the generosity could be shown to a certain limit, not more than that. So magnanimity has its limits, he says in the lesson. So this generosity could be shown to a certain limit. Gardiner decided to kill it. Here will be kill. He adopted many tactics to get hold and kill the mosquito, but every time it escaped. It was quite courageous, it was sportive, so it escaped. Sahyatri, जो कि एक मच्छर था, उसने लेखक को बार बार परेशान किया और लेखक ने उसको मारना चाहा, मारने की कोशिश की. फिर वो आकर के बहुत ही साहसपूर्वक लेखक के पास आके बैठ गया. लेखक को बहुत गुस्सा आया और उन्होंने कहा कि उदारता की भी एक सीमा होती है, एक निश्चित सीमा तक ही कोई उदारता दिखा सकता है, उसके बाद नहीं. गार्डिनर ने डिसाइड किया और उन्होंने कई तरह की टैक्टिसेस, फेलाइन टैक्टिसेस ही अडॉप्टेड, कैट लाइक टैक्टिसेस ही अडॉप्टेड. उन्होंने कई तरह के टैक्टिसेस, कई तरह की स्ट्रेटजी, रणनीति बनाई, तरीके अपनाए उसको मारने के, लेकिन वो असफल रहा. हर टाइम मच्छर बचता रहा. द मॉस्किटो वॉज ट्राइंग टू प्रूव हिमसेल्फ टू बी द बुल फाइटर वाइल द ऑथर कंपेयर्ड हिमसेल्फ टू द bull. Now you can imagine the bull fighting. So here the mosquito has been compared to the bull fighter and the author himself compared to the bull. So he uses the word skillful matador. He accepted that the mosquito also was not only an ordinary insect, but it also had a personality of its own. It is not mere an insect, it had its own identity. The author felt like that. The writer decided to be magnanimous and merciful because by developing these two qualities, he would be able to get back his lost prestige. The writer thought, now there is one way. He needs to be magnanimous, he needs to be merciful. In this way, he could gain his lost prestige. Mosquito, मच्छर जो है एक सांड से लड़ने वाले की तरह से, जैसे इंसान लड़ता है बुल फाइटिंग में, जब सांड से लड़ने के खेल का प्रदर्शन होता है, उसमें उसकी तुलना बुल फाइटर से और लेखक ने अपनी तुलना सांड से की है. उसने ही एक्सेप्टेड, उन्होंने लास्ट में ये एक्सेप्ट किया लेखक ने कि मॉस्किटो, मच्छर जो है वो केवल एक कीड़ा नहीं है बल्कि उसका भी अपना एक अस्तित्व है. लेखक ने डिसाइड किया कि उन्हें बहुत ही उदार और दयापूर्ण होने की ज़रूरत है, दयावान होने की ज़रूरत है, क्योंकि इन दो क्वालिटीज़ के द्वारा ही, इन दो गुणों को अपना करके ही वो अपनी खोई हुई प्रतिष्ठा को वापस पा सकते हैं. Impudently, boldly, साहसपूर्वक, august, majestic, शानदार, शाही. Resents, feels angry, नाराज होना. Tickling, causing uneasy sensation, गुदगुदाहट. Impertinence, disrespect, असम्मान. Vagrant, wanderer, घुमंतू होना. Misdemeanors, unlawful acts, जो कानूनी रूप से सही ना हो. Lethal, deadly, घातक. Humiliated, insulted, अपमानित. Lunged at, to move forward suddenly, अचानक से आगे बढ़ा. Tactics, strategy, ostentatiously, pretentious और showy way, आडंबर, दिखावा. Infuriated, made angry, गुस्सा होना. Magnanimous, liberal, उदार होना. Derision, मौकरी, मजाक उड़ाना. Now we have paragraph 6th and 7th. The author had formally decided not to kill the mosquito, his fellow traveler. The writer decided that he would not kill the mosquito. He assured the mosquito that he would keep his word because he developed a feeling of affection for it. Earlier, he had a feeling of enmity for the mosquito, but later on what happened, he felt that there is a kind of affection in his heart for the mosquito, for a love for the mosquito. He thought that both were mortals and fortune had made them fellow travelers. He thought that both of them had the same condition, and it is the luck that they met in the compartment. He says, we are just like apparitions. We are the spirit of dead body that are then are not. Their existence was like a bubble. Sometime it appeared and then it disappeared very soon. At last, a porter asked him to come out. He came out and saw his fellow traveler fluttering round the lamp. At last, what happened? A porter came and he told the author to come out as he reached the destination, and the author found that the mosquito was fluttering in the same way as it was in the beginning. So लेखक जो है वो पूरी तरह से निश्चित करते हैं कि वो मच्छर को नहीं मारेंगे, और उन्होंने ये बात मच्छर को आश्वस्त किया कि उनके हृदय में उसके लिए एक स्नेह है. उन्होंने सोचा कि दोनों जो हैं वो नश्वर हैं, और यह एक भाग्य की बात है कि दोनों आज इस ट्रेन में सहयात्री हैं. ही सेज वी आर जस्ट लाइक, हम लोग एक आत्मा की तरह से हैं और एक बुलबुले की तरह अस्तित्व है. कभी हमारा अस्तित्व है और कल नहीं होगा. एट लास्ट अ पोर्टर, फिर एक कूली आता है, वो लेखक को जगाता है, बताता है कि उनका स्टेशन आ चुका है. लेखक उतर जाते हैं और वो पाते हैं कि उनका जो सहयात्री यानी कि मच्छर, वो वैसे ही ट्रेन में मडराता रहता है. लेट्स हैव द वर्ड मीनिंग. कॉर्प्स, डेड बॉडी, मृत शरीर. ऑब्लिगेशन, मॉरल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, नैतिक जिम्मेदारी. मिरेकल, वंडर, आश्चर्य. मिस्ट्री, सीक्रेट, रहस्य. सीजिंग, होल्डिंग, पकड़ना. अपरिशंस, द स्पिरिट ऑफ डेड बॉडी, मृत शरीर की आत्मा. अ स्मैक्ड, साउंड ऑफ ब्लो गिवन विद ओपन हैंड, तो दोनों हाथों से मारना, उससे जो आवाज़ निकलती है. नाउ इट्स टाइम फॉर इवैल्यूएशन, सो लेट्स चेक हियर. What does the abbreviation DORA stand for? DORA stands for the Defense of Realm Act. It was a kind of power that was given to the British government in the year 1914. Who was the fellow traveler? This is very easy question. The mosquito was the fellow traveler. Who are referred to as the skillful matador? As we were discussing in the paragraph, we found out the skillful matador was the mosquito and the infuriated bull was the author. Why did the author feel humiliated and how did he react to it? The author felt humiliated because he tried many times to kill the mosquito, but it was all in vain. So he decided to be magnanimous and merciful towards the mosquito. Now it's time for homework. Dear students, there are two questions. First, what things could you do if you are traveling alone in a compartment? It's a quite interesting question and you must answer it, that what could be done by you. Second, explain with reference to the context the following passage, the miracle about mine. So here you have to write the reference, context and then explanation. In reference you have to mention the name of the lesson and the name of the author. Then you have to write the context where you have to mention the main theme. After that you have to write the explanation, and then you can add comments where you can find out the theme, the language, whatever you find out is special, you can write it. Now we have reached the last segment. that is the message. It shows the ability to be compassionate towards another living creature. So compassion is the best quality that we should try to inculcate in our self. So here we learned how can one be compassionate towards the living creature, as we found out for the mosquito. Second, an individual should take the full advantage of the freedom, like the mosquito does, being free from obstruction or societal views. Whenever we get the opportunity of freedom, we should try to avail. Next, the story condemns superiority complex. No one should feel superior to anyone. No one is superior, no one is inferior. So this feeling should not be there. Fourth, the miracle and mystery of life are common for every living creature on this earth. As we know that in the last segment of the lesson, he said that the miracle and mystery of life are common, both for mortals, fellow mortals. So we have the same history and we don't know about our destination, where have we to go finally. So in this way, we find a kind of similarity here. Dear students, now we have completed this lesson. I hope you must have grasped the ideas and you must have enjoyed the entire lesson. Till then, be happy, stay safe and keep on learning. Thank you very much.